If the city does try to come in here and get you out, what are you going to do?
We're going to do what's necessary, man.
What is that?
But first, understand why he's coming in here.
What are you going to do?
All right, we're going to do what's necessary.
What is that?
The strategy of giant Africa.
What is that?
Our only defense.
What is that?
The strategy of giant Africa.
Yeah, you aren't telling me anything. You're just saying the strategy.
Hey, I wouldn't tell my strategy to you.
What do you, expect them? Do you expect them to come in?
Confrontation in Philadelphia between MOVE and the RISO administration forces was frozen in photographs and splashed across the press of the nation. Pictured was surrendering MOVE member Delbert Africa being beat and kicked by four policemen. Moments earlier, Officer James Ramp was shot dead. Fourth largest in the country, Philadelphia is a city whose black population has tripled since the Second World War. In the wake of the civil unrest of the 60s, then police commissioner Frank Rizzo ran for mayor on a law and order platform and won. The year Rizzo took office in 1972 was the same year that the MOVE organization, comprised of the family Africa, began to mobilize. MOVE demonstrated against police stations, school board officials, and public figures such as Jane Fonda, Jesse Jackson, and a variety of others who would, in their words, mislead the people with misinformation, offering only the problem and not a solution.
Completely disrupted the meeting, and I and Jane Fonda and Tom Hayden walked out, and I walked out, and most of us walked out.
The media has called MOVE a back to nature group of radicals, the human species at its lowest form, and finally wrote, "The word MOVE means nothing at all." In response to the press, Delbert Africa wrote, "MOVE means what it says. MOVE, get active, change, revolution."
Listen to what John Africa writes. This is a quote from him. The MOVE organization is a powerful family of revolutionaries, fixed in principle, strong in cohesion, steady as the foundation of a massive tree. Long live John Africa, hero!
MOVE says John Africa is our founder and goes by no other name. The media has identified John Africa as Vincent Leapart, a third grade dropout and handyman who lived in an area of Philadelphia known as Powelton Village.
That man didn't even complete elementary school. He can neither read nor write.
You're talking about education.
But his wisdom surpasses any man's walk on the face of this earth. He's got all answers for everything. Every question you could ask, he got the answer for it. This is what John Africa gave us. And we tell anybody, if you say you got it, you better be right.
Spring of 1975, some of MOVE's Powelton Village neighbors complained to the city of threats, the smell of garbage and rats. City officials announced plans to coordinate a health and housing inspection. MOVE refused to let them in. Year after year, MOVE's encounter with the police ended in injuries and arrest. By 1975, MOVE members had been arrested hundreds of times, with bail amounting close to $1 million. They reacted by strengthening their religious discipline and securing their homes from intrusion. Court, they represented each other. In jail, they went on hunger strikes. On each side, the charges mounted. MOVE accused the city of systematic persecution and violence, resulting in two stillbirths and the death of an infant crushed in a police attack. The city charged MOVE with everything short of larceny and murder, climaxing with a plot to obtain nuclear weapons. On May 20th, 1977, MOVE brandished weapons from their Powelton Village headquarters platform, saying no longer will we be beaten or intimidated by the police without a like response.
It's because we know the psychological effect that it has on them cops, all right? Them cops was thinking about their individual lives. That's why we had guns. We knew that Rizzo had to come to us if you wanted to make an arrest. So the guns was used to narrow down the arrest.
From that day on, constant police surveillance, which lasted a year, surrounded the MOVE compound, costing the city millions of dollars. MOVE sparked a significant amount of community support by speaking out on police abuse. Many demonstrations were held as hundreds of people rallied to MOVE's defense. Early March of the following year, Rizzo announced that if MOVE did not leave their headquarters, the city would erect the blockade so tight, even a fly wouldn't be able to get in. March 16, 1978, a blockade went up involving 1,000 police officers. That night, Rizzo launched a campaign urging armed whites to fight blacks for better jobs, decent housing, and a better life. The day before, he announced that he would drop his bid for a third term as mayor. During the next 55 days, residents of the barricaded area carry passbooks and were subject to body checks. Police marksmen set in windows and behind sandbags across the street. No food or water was permitted to enter the MOVE compound. On May 9th, MOVE surrendered its weapons and allowed the city to search their home. In the form of a court order, the city gave MOVE 90 days to move. August 2nd, 1978, the 90 days were up and MOVE had not left their headquarters.
Ain't no deadline as far as the teachings of John Africa go. This is our house. We're gonna always be here. We ain't gonna never recognize no deadline set by no sadistic goon like Rizzo.
MOVE, its supporters, the media and police waited and prepared themselves for the confrontation as a judge issued warrants against 21 MOVE members for violating the original court order.
Petition and accompanying affidavits and upon mention of Sheldon A. Albert, city solicitor, attorney for the plaintiff petitioner, a rule is hereby granted upon Janet Holloway, Consuela Dotson, Janine Africa, Charles Sims,
Edward Goodman, every time you civilized maniacs murder,
Merrill Austin,
somebody,
Alberta Wicker, Sharon Penn, Gail Debbie Sims, Dennis Sims, Frank James, Philip Smith, Delbert Orr, Carlos Perez, Rhonda Ward, Debbie Zelda Sims, Michael Davis, Raymond Chester, Robert Moses, Sue Leon, Conrad Hamp.
We ain't gonna give it to you. Come on with it. You ain't gotta come up here with
occupying
that.
Occupying or residing the premises, 307 309 North 33rd Street, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, to show cause why attachments with a contempt of court.
You see us right here.
You see the court right here, man. Why should we go to court to give some kind of sanction to this so-called legal murder?
Is it gonna stop him from killing us? We've been going to court for 6 years and Rizzo's still talking about bringing his bullshit to our door, talking about bringing his Gestapo troops in our home.
Talking about law and order, you've been talking about murder at the same time. Talking about he gonna concern for kids while steadily arming them SWAT troops, them fat, filthy cops up there with machine guns and all other kind of gap-dealing merchandise. And talking about he concerned about somebody. This man is talking about killing somebody over a so-called civil contempt of court. Since when has death been the penalties for contempt of court?
And we saying, don't look at MOVE as crazy. Look at your boss as crazy. When you got somebody that's talking about